Probably can't even see that, but that's the chopper copper. Haven't seen that for years. Must be something serious going on. Probably a car driver gone through a speed camera or something.
Guy was a young boy. A school teacher brought it to school. A moped engine. And he put it into the workshop price. And then he started it up with an old piece of rope. And the smell and the sound changed my life forever.
Right then, let's get this selector box back on. I think they're the right parts. So without further ado, let's go for a poo.
Yeah.
I think that's the main bolt. That goes on there first. That go on there. Ah, wrong way. Yep, right way. And that rubber must go on the top. I think that's right. Which way does it go? Does it go that way? Or did it go that way? I tell you what, the main manuals are crap. Don't even tell you, don't even show you this in the book. I'll go for that way first. Just hope this is the right way round. Probably not. Don't think that's the right way because we're going to the bracket. So that is not the right way round. So let's put it on the right way round, shall we? So if you're doing this very same job, probably not, but you know, you never know. The bracket lip clip thing goes into the front of the engine. And the torque wrench settings for these bolts are, I can't even be bothered to look. Must be that way. So now I want a 14mm socket. So there's my 14mm socket. And there we are, one selector box. What next? Before we go too far, let's try and slacken this oil filter off before it's too late. Proving difficult. Proven very difficult. Get a bit of a bar on it. Bloody hell. Whew. tell you what, I've had some odd oil filters in my time, but I'm pretty sure that's the oddest one I've ever had. Think that needs replacing, don't you? Leave it on for now because I don't want oil dripping. Put our four clamps on. Okay, so there's my damn pipes. 1, 2, 3, 4. My new gasket. My old gaskets. Get on with it. Guess we'll learn some up there. Put the middle two in first. So that's the first one on. Okay, let's try the next one. Whoa. Finally got the damn pipes on. What next? Okay, let's have a go at the main stand. I'm gonna put some grease in here first. Okay, let's try and get the spring on. I think that's going to snap, don't you? could put some on it and give it a really good pull, but I'll probably go flying through the shed wall. Slightly of a screwdriver, shall we? Simple. This is my other frame bar for the engine, and I haven't done anything with it yet because the two different paints have started to react. So I'm going to strip it all off and start again. Almost harder than doing the frame. See all this yellow powder? See how it's sort of stuck on there? It's making it crozzle. So I've got to get it back to the bare metal, and it's pretty tough, that stuff. And it's this spray body filler. Okay, let's get the frame section back in. So now I've got to try and get the, back bumper then, back mudguard in. And I know it was very difficult getting it out, so I'm pretty sure this is going to be a tough job. Well, that was easy enough. Time to open my new 6mm bolts, Roy. Leave them in there, can't I? What next? Let's do the starter motor. It's a bit tricky, don't it, to get to that. I'll just leave it loose for now. Yep, I'll just leave it loose for now because I don't know if I can get the wire on. Let's whack the coil on. Okay, let's try and install the wire loom, wiring loom. I'm pretty sure this is the front end because that's the headlight plug. So that must be the front, and then all this goes to the back. See what we can do. Can't even remember if it was on the left side or the right side of the frame. We'll suss it out. Okay, so there's the battery bit, so must be somewhere now. I have no idea about what to pull it through with yet, but I'm sure it will all become apparent as we start plugging things back in. Just about to drop the railroad guard again because the wire loom goes underneath. These little babies go on these little babies. I don't know where that goes. Now then, are the wires sticking up or sticking down? According to that, the wires are downwards, so we will do it. So that one goes on there. That's the big one. Goes on there. And the little one goes on there. La-di-da-da. What these go to. That goes there as well, doesn't it? I wonder where that goes. Main street, oh, that goes. They go over that side to the... over that side to the CDI unit. So I think we're getting a bit closer. This one's for the indicators. That one's for like the starter relay. And this one is for the carburetor heaters. Yes, I think that will go down there. I think this starter relay, it's got two prongs. Goes in them two there, one here and one there. That is that. So I'd imagine that goes in those two prongs, but which side does the wire go? Pretty sure it is on the left. Terminal must go through there. Let's get the CDI back on. The CDI goes with the plug sockets to the back. Maybe I should work out what goes on there first, isn't it? These come through there somewhere. They must come through there. That is the main fuse, and that goes on there. So, and they must plug into there. Like so. That bolts onto there. You would have thought there'd be some cush drive on there, wouldn't you? But no? The bottom screw in. Yeah. Somebody's hoovering up. Rattle about like that. Then that should have a rub around it, and that goes on there, I think. Okay, back to the fuse box. Found the fuse rubber. And we found the lid too. the lid to. I think we're going to get that one. Oh, no, hold on. Feels a bit loose, but that'll do. So now it's time to wire the coils up. And my God, which wire goes where? I don't know if you remember, but it's a good job. We took a snapshot, so I know exactly where the wires go. Red, grey, red, orange. Simple. So it's red on the bottom, the earth goes onto that bolt obviously. Let's do these first. Red onto the bottom. That didn't feel very good. Better. And what was it? Orange on the top. The one red on the top. Red on the top. That must mean grey on the bottom. And then these two are for, I ain't got a clue. Thank God for snapshots. So let's get the back light back in. Say there for the indicators. That one goes into the main harness. Maybe that's not quite right. Maybe it went underneath there. Should be a multi plug around here, so wait. And there should be. Perfect. Time to fit the solenoid to the starter motor. We've got to thread the wire through here. And that goes on there somewhere. It'd be easier if I take the starter motor back off, wouldn't it? now because I've got the wrong socket. I've lost my nut. My nuts have finally dropped. It somehow goes onto there. Must be it like that. Like to make it too easy, do they? Try it with a socket. There we are. Well, I don't know about you guys, but I've had enough for today. It's been a long video. Very long video. Got quite a lot to show for it, I think. So, hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe. Thumbs up. Please leave a thumbs up. And take care. See you again soon.
I'll see you in another life, brother!